Welcome back again in LADALIDI's tutorials. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to create this realistic UI design 3D button like this. You don't need a 3-dimensional software to create a 3D UI button like this one. All you need is Adobe Illustrator. So don't skip this video and let's jump straight into Adobe Illustrator. Here I have prepared a document with an artboard size of 1920 by 1080 pixels. The first thing we need to do is create a background. Create a rectangle using the rectangle tool and make it according to the size of the artboard. After we created it, we're going to give it a gradient color. Open the gradient panel in the window menu and look for gradient. In the gradient panel, click the gradient annotator and that will give us a default black and white gradient. First, change the angle to 90 degrees. Click on one of the color stops to change the color. For this one, I will give it a color that is in the color palette that I have prepared. And for the other color stop, color it with a lighter color. After we give it a gradient color, go to the object menu, lock, selection, so this rectangle will be locked and will not be selected by accident. Now it's time for us to create a 3D button with a skeuomorphism style. First of all, we're gonna create the middle part first. Create a circle using the ellipse tool with a size of 380 by 380 pixels and remove the stroke color on the toolbar. Just by select the stroke box and click done button below it. Click this fill box again, so if you work with colors, only this fill color will be affected. If you look at the 3D button that I've made, it looks like a circular brushed aluminum metal. So we're gonna create this part first. I have made a video tutorial about this, on how to create a circular brushed aluminum metal Adobe Illustrator tutorial. You can open it on the card above, or open the link in the description box. To create an effect like this, we need a gradient color, but not the gradient type that usually comes with gradient type on the gradient panel. It's like a gradient with angle style in Adobe Photoshop, but as the basis for this type of angle style, we still have to use gradient color. Open the swatches panel in the window menu. Click this black and white default gradient color. Then open the gradient panel and change the gradient type to radial. Once we've applied this radial gradient color to this circle, go to the object menu, expand, and select the gradient mesh on the expand gradient to tap and click OK. This aims to expand the radial gradient color into a gradient mesh color so we can modify this color specifically. Right click on this circle object, ungroup, right click again, and click release clipping mask because this gradient mesh is inside the mask, so we need to remove it. Select the circle that was previously masked and delete it because we don't need it. Now we are going to modify the colors in this gradient mesh. If you see a blue line in it, then it should be a mesh line and we're going to put a color there. Click the mesh tool on the toolbar. Click right on the mesh line to add another mesh line. Add 3 more mesh lines on the other side so that it forms a next. Now it's time to modify the colors. Use the direct selection tool to select the 2 anchor points at the top of the circle. While these 2 anchor points are still selected, activate the eyedropper tool on the toolbar and pick a dark gray color in the color palette. Reactivate the direct selection tool without having to click on it, then pick a light gray color. Do the same for the other anchor points. Activate direct selection without clicking on it and pick a dark gray color. Did you see what I just did? I went back and forth using the direct selection tool with the eyedropper tool without having to activate the direct selection tool in the toolbar. In Adobe Illustrator, we're able to move between tools without having to go back and forth clicking on them on the toolbar. The goal is to save our time, as I show you here. I can activate the direct selection tool instantly without having to click on it, while the eyedropper tool is active. You can see it here. The eyedropper tool is active and instantly I can use the direct selection tool without having to click on it. You can see the icon on my cursor. We only need to press Ctrl key on the keyboard if you are using PC and Command if you are using a Mac. Release it if you want to use the eyedropper tool function. Let's try again. As you can see here, the eyedropper tool is active. Press Ctrl or Command, select two anchor points by dragging, release Ctrl or Command and pick a color from the color palette. Let's do it again, hit Ctrl or Command and select anchor points, release Ctrl or Command and pick color. Do the same for all the remaining anchor points, and the result will be like this. For a while, it has looked like a round metal effect. Before continuing, I will reduce the size to its original size, which is 380 by 380 pixels, because after we expand it, the size has also been expanded. Create another circle with a size of 300 by 300 pixels. Place it in the middle. On the toolbar, in the Fill and Stroke box, click Swap Fill and Stroke to change the fill color to the stroke. Then click the stroke box until it is above the fill box because we will be working with this stroke only. Open the gradient panel and click the gradient annotator to apply this gradient color to the stroke. Then change the gradient angle to 90 degrees. And gradient type to linear gradient. Don't forget to change the color of these two color stops, in the left with the lightest gray and the other with the dark gray. And we are done with this part. Now we're going to make a chamfer for this button so that it looks like more three-dimensional object. Create another circle with a size of 4 and 10 by 4 and 10 pixels. Activate the fill box on the fill and stroke box. Open the gradient panel and change the gradient angle to 90 degrees. For the color on the left color stop, give the color with the third gray color in the palette, activate the color picker below it and pick the color. And for the other color stop, color it with the lightest gray color. Place it again in the middle, right click, arrange, send backward, right click again, arrange, and send backward, or do it until this circle is at the bottom. After that, go to the object menu, path and offset path. Fill the offset with 3 pixels and click OK. Use the eyedropper tool and pick a black color from the palette. And we're done for the button body, with the illusion of a 3-dimensional chamfer around it and this black color as the hole where this button is. Next, we're going to give it a shadow effect to make it more realistic. Select this black circle, then go to the effect menu, style, drop shadow. In the drop shadow panel, make sure the color is black, the mode is multiply, and the opacity is 75%. Then change the X offset to 0 pixels, Y offset to 15 pixels, and blur to 10 pixels. And click OK. Now we are going to make it a hollow effect around the button. Create a new circle with a size of 490 by 490 pixels. Right click on that circle, arrange, turn backward. Do this until this new circle is at the bottom. Now we just give it a gradient color, but this time we don't need to create it from scratch. We just use the eyedropper tool on the toolbar and pick the gradient color on this chamfer object. After getting the gradient color, open the gradient panel and change the angle to minus 90 degrees. Next, go to the object menu, path, offset path, and fill the offset to 2 pixels. Open the gradient panel, click the color stop on the left and activate the color picker below it. Pick the fourth gray color, and for the other color stop, give the lightest gray. And done! We finished creating this 3-dimensional button in a simple skeuomorphism style. Now we move to the next step, which is the last step by making it even more realistic, which is we're gonna give it a texture, so that at the top of this button, there is a radial brushed metal effect. Create another circle with a size of 4 and 10 by 4 and 10 pixels and place it right above this round metal. Use the eyedropper tool and pick a color in the color palette. Go to the effect menu, texture, and click this grain. In this grain panel, set the intensity to 60 and 0 for contrast. Click OK. Back again to the effect menu, blur, Radial Blur, fill the amount with 30. Blur method with spin and set it to best quality. Next, open the transparency panel in the window menu. Change the blending mode to soft light and change the opacity to 35%. Now we have a circular brush texture. It looks like an aluminum metal with circular brush. Select all the objects, right click, group, and done. To add a sense of function to this button, we just need to give it a power icon so that it looks like it's a power button. You can also color the power icon to impress the button is on. The rest, you can experiment with using this button to create various types of other 3D buttons, because there are so many possibilities that you can create just by using this technique. I hope this tutorial was useful. Don't forget to press the subscribe button and the notification bell so that every time I upload a video, you will get a notification. Don't forget to follow LADALIDI's Instagram. The link is in the description box, and see you in the next video.